In this video, we are going to look at differentiating characteristics of lumbosacral radicular syndrome and intermittent neurogenic claudication. Get our very own assessment ebook and mobile app. Links are in the video description. Hi and welcome back to Physio Tutors. When a patient presents to you with back pain and neurological symptoms in the legs, you should know what characterizes a stenotic clinical picture compared to that of a lumbar radicular syndrome. Putting the two side by side in terms of their peak incidence, course, pain description, localization, provoking moments and relieving situations, as well as physical examination findings will show you how to differentiate between the two. First of all, lumbar radicular syndrome is most often seen in younger adults between 30 to 65, whereas stenosis is most prevalent from the 6th decade on. A patient with radicular syndrome will describe rather acute or subacute onset of symptoms, and LRS has a favorable course where 60% recover spontaneously within 12 weeks. A patient with intermittent neurogenic claudication reports an insidious onset, and the course of stenosis is rather progressive until it reaches a plateau. Some may experience exacerbations or spontaneous improvement. A clear distinction can be made in terms of pain characteristic. The pain in LRS is distinct, sharp, and burning, like a narrow band down the leg, and is often described as being worse than the back pain itself. With intermittent neurogenic claudication, the pain is dull, aching, and the legs feel tired or heavy. LRS typically presents unilaterally, whereas the symptoms of stenosis can occur bilaterally, requiring the patient to sit down. The latter fact is the perfect segue into what provokes symptoms in both cases. Symptoms of radicular syndrome are intensified whenever pressure is increased, such as during coughing, standing and sitting, or walking. Patients are desperately looking for a comfortable position. A stenotic patient describes onset of symptoms during standing or walking with a straight back. These positions require lumbar extension and cause narrowing of the intervertebral foramen. The patient finds relief when biking, sitting down, bending over, or squatting with a round back. A patient with LRS will prefer to be lying than anything else. At last, the physical examination procedure in LRS will involve assessing for signs of radiculopathy, so changes in dermatomal sensation, diminished strength or reflexes, as well as positive provocative tests, such as the straight leg raise test. In intermittent neurogenic claudication, there are usually no abnormal findings. Okay, thanks for watching this theoretical video on differentiating between LRS and intermittent neurogenic claudication based on their clinical presentation. Now, if you'd like, continue by watching our video on differentiating between radicular and somatic referred pain in the lumbar spine by clicking on the left. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, and we appreciate if you subscribe to our channel and hit the little bell next to the subscribe button. The video description is full with useful links, so make sure to check those out as well. And as always, this was Andreas for Physio Tutors. I'll see you next time. Bye.